How you doing? Thanks so much for being here. I'm Instructor Dwayne Jenkins. Welcome to Dwayne's Guitar Lessons. If this is the first time being here, I want to say welcome. You've been here before, I want to say welcome back. Today's video, we're going to be talking a little bit more about lead guitar playing and what the best scale to use for playing lead guitar. Stick around and I'll show you which one it is. Alright, so the best scale to use for playing lead guitar by far is the minor pentatonic scale. This one right here. We'll just play it right here in A minor, okay? Now if you were playing in A minor, it would be 5-8, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-8, 5-8. And then if you go back, it would be 8-5-8-5-7-5-7-5-7-5-8-5. Now I would recommend if you're playing lead guitar, master that scale. Be able to play it all over the fretboard. It's very, very important. It's a great scale. It works with unlimited opportunities in it, and it works with unlimited chord progressions in any key, major, minor, doesn't matter. It works really well with minor keys, but also can work with major chord progressions as well. So I would highly recommend that you master the scale. Okay, that's the very first thing. Second of all, I'd master all five of the patterns. There's five patterns. This is just one of them. If you're playing an A, that would be pattern one. Pattern two would be here at the eighth fret. Pattern 3 would be here at the 10th fret. Pattern 4 would be here at the 12th fret. Pattern 5 would be here at the 15th fret. And then that leads us back to pattern 1. In the next octave, right here at the 17th fret. And you know that to be true because you can hear it. Same notes. And since pattern 5 is here at the 15th fret up here, you can also play it here at the 3rd fret. Think about it, you get to span all the way up the whole fretboard with those five patterns. So I highly recommend learn all five of the minor they're actually just pentatonic scales. They can be used both for minor and major. But this first one that I'm showing you, which is the most common that everybody knows and plays, all the great guitar players play it, is the minor pentatonic. And it's the reason why is because most rock and blues is in a minor key. So this is the one you want to learn first. And it's real easy to play too, so I highly recommend you learn that. Now, number two, what you want to do is you want to take four notes from pattern five behind it and use it as an extension to pattern one. So if you use the, if you're playing in an A minor here at the 5th fret, and you use the 3-5 from the 5th pattern right behind it on the 6th and 5th string, that's an A right there. Now you've extended the pattern out a little bit. You haven't used all the notes, but just those ones right there. So if you start there, slide into the first pattern. Now we've extended that pattern, and so the next one we'd want to do is we want to take some notes out of the second pattern that's right next to the first one right here, and we'll take it to 7, 9, 8, 10, 8, 10 on the 3rd, 2nd, and 1st string. So there's six notes there we want to take. And this one right here is kind of in both patterns, the first and the second pattern. So it'd actually be this pattern here, 9, 8, 10, 8, 10. And then one more, the 12 out of the third pattern right here. And you want, see how we went to the A. It's all in A right there. And what's great about this particular pattern, if you use these notes, you never have to really extend this kind of stuff here. Like some people have a hard time using their pinky. Some people have a hard time extending that third finger to cover two frets like this in between on some of these strings. So by using this pattern, you don't have to do that. All the notes are going to be just the index and the ring finger apart. If you watch, you can see that I'm just using those two fingers. Now you can use the middle finger as a passing note. Maybe use the middle finger for that note right there. So I would highly recommend work on that. Okay? So, you use four notes from pattern five. Use, I'd say six notes, five if you want to really be technical. This note at the 9, 8, 10, 8, 10, those are all come from pattern two. And then the 12th fret is from pattern three. So pattern one, pattern five, pattern one, pattern two, and then pattern three. And what's great about the thing about the lead guitar playing is that it's all in patterns. So if you just really think about patterns, 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 I've said this many times in my videos, you should think patterns. If you think patterns, you see that visual on the fretboard, okay? I had a student was telling me some about, he said, yeah, when I look at the sheet music, I can see everything, it's right there. It's like looking at a map, and that's true. Now what you want to do, if you can do that, great. What you want to do is look at your fretboard. Fretboard as the map, okay? The fretboard is now the roadmap. And if you master these patterns on your fretboard, and it really comes from just doing it all the time, just like studying sheet music. You can't really master it unless you study it all the time. Well, same thing with this. You just study your guitar all the time. You see these patterns. You study the notes. Study the pattern, and you'll be able to play it every time. Then, lastly, what you want to do is transpose it to different keys. If you're playing in G, say G minor right here, you just go back two frets to start these notes in the fifth string, the fifth pattern like we did in A, but now we're at the first fret. Same pattern, we just moved everything down a fret, or down two frets, I'm sorry, for G. Let's say you wanted to move it up to, say, the key of B minor, which is at the seventh fret. Same exact thing, you move down two frets to the A. Same exact pattern. And if you just study that and you master it, I guarantee you're gonna sound great every single time. You're gonna be in key. Somebody throws something at you, you'll be able to play with no problem. And sound great, because you'll be in key. Just a matter of mastering that pattern and knowing those notes. And it just comes with a matter of practicing it every single day. If you work with it every day, your ear will start to get trained and your visualization will start to develop and knowing the pattern and seeing the notes. And once you get to that point, you'll be able to improvise and do whatever you want to do because you'll know where those patterns are. All right, so there we go. Five things to study. Number one, study the five pentatonic scale patterns. They could be used both in minor and major progressions. Number two, take notes from pattern five and incorporate them into pattern one. Number three, take five notes from pattern two and incorporate those into pattern one. Number four, take that one note from pattern three and incorporate that into pattern one along with two and five. And number five, once you get it studied and you get it mastered in one key, like to start in A minor, learn to transpose into other keys, G, B, C, D, E, F. And then you'll be able to master the fretboard. And when somebody comes along, you start playing with somebody and they say, yeah, I got a song key of G, boom, you'll know where to play. Got a song in the key of B, you'll know where to play. And you'll be able to do the same thing every single time and you'll sound good. But you gotta practice, gotta work with it every day, all right? So work on that, master that. Study that. And if you'd like to learn more about that, I recommend you check out this book I wrote. It's called How to Play Guitar Solos. You can find it on Amazon. As you can see, it's pretty thick. It's got all the diagrams of the patterns in it. I've got some, it's all written in tabs, so it's really easy to understand even if you have no musical training. It's a step-by-step method book, and it shows you the patterns. And it shows you how they work, and it shows you how to create licks and solos out of them. So if you're looking at how to learn how to play solos, I'd highly recommend check out this book. You can find it on Amazon. I'll leave you the link below. And keep watching the channel, because I'm going to be going through these five patterns in some of our next few videos, and it's going to show you exactly a little more in detail how this stuff is going to work for you. All right? So keep practicing, and I'll see you in our next lesson.